Greetings. Quick reminder, these are the next three claims in Deedat's Absurdity Jihad of Deedat's Combat Kit. C. Birth of Females a Double Pollution, from Leviticus 12, 1, 2, and 5. Shamgar kills 600 with an ox goad, Judges 3, 31. E. Samson kills 1,000 with the jawbone of a donkey, Judges 15, 15 through 16. Let's continue with the next assertion in Deedat's interesting Absurdity Jihad. C. The birth of females a double pollution. Leviticus 12:1. Then the Lord said to Moses, "Say to the Israelites, a woman who becomes pregnant and gives birth to a son will be unclean for 7 days, as she is during the days of her menstruation. And on the eighth day the flesh of the boy's foreskin is to be circumcised." He skips this verse entirely. Evidently, Deedat has no issue with male circumcision as absurd. Nor does he ascribe motive or address why the eighth. Why not the fifth, or the seventh, or the twelfth? The woman shall continue in purification from her bleeding for 33 days. She must not touch anything sacred, or go into the sanctuary until the days of her purification are complete. If, however, she gives birth to a daughter, the woman will be unclean for 2 weeks, as she is during her menstruation. Then she must continue in purification from her bleeding for 66 days. So Deedat's undies are in a bundle because God gives different purification restrictions for girls and boys. Is this really the jihad that Mohammedism must wage to attempt to discredit the Torah that Moses revealed? The Torah, the Quran, says to respect as equal with the Quran, to show no distinction. Seriously, Deedat thinks an ordinance from God is absurd? The more I learn how Islam, quote-unquote, thinks, the less it has any possible place in the rational universe. The worst logical problem with Deedat's absurd jihad is his conclusion. Birth of females is a double pollution. God's ordinance is a prescription, not a condemnation or a rationale. And Jehovah God, the creator of man and woman, may just have a reason he has not revealed. But since Mohammedism has conditioned Deedat to think he is smarter than Jehovah God, his creator, he thinks the Torah, brought by Moses, revealed by God, is absurd. Beyond that disrespect, this argument is as irrational as calling Islam's 5 times of prayer absurd, because, well, someone hates the number 5. The correct answer is 3. 3 times. Morning, noon, and night. Or for Christians, they must pray without ceasing, because they are already citizens of God's spiritual kingdom and able to do so. Calling God's prescription absurd just means, according to the Word of God, Deedat is a man of no spiritual discernment. 1 Corinthians 2:14. The natural man does not accept the things that come from the Spirit of God, for they, the things that come from the Spirit of God, are foolishness to him, and he cannot understand them, because they are spiritually discerned. In a spirit of charity, I would encourage prayer for one as ignorant as Deedat, but he is dead in his sins at this point. If you are Muslim, you do not have to die in your sins, as Deedat did. Point D. Shamgar kills 600 with an ox goad. Judges 3:31. Judges 3:31. After Ehud came Shamgar, son of Anath, and he too saved Israel, striking down 600 Philistines with an ox goad. First thought, there are just too many flippant comebacks possible to this next salvo of Deedat's stupid blizzard of blindness. It does not say he killed them all at the same time, or with only one swing of an ox goad. And you have seen the Philistines fight. They can only kill defenseless women and children at bus stops by cowardly attack on innocent, peaceful, unprepared people. Seriously, the modern Arabs in Judea and Samaria are not the descendants of the Philistines. But is killing 600 an absurd, irrational claim, as Deedat hopes to discredit the Torah and the Bible and the Gospel by mocking? I can actually see where Deedat is coming from, because his Ilah, called Allah, was impotent and remains impotent since Muhammad invented him. There was not one single documented miracle in the Quran. Only claims that the God of the Jews was this imagined Ilah of Muhammad. So to him, any such victory must be impossible. Absurd. The Allah of Islam could not beat 50 Frenchmen drunk with wine. But is this historical account in the Bible absurd? Deedat certainly did not prove it. He only revealed that his Ilah was impotent. Absurdity E. Samson kills 1,000 with the jawbone of a donkey. Judges 15:15-16. And he found a fresh jawbone of a donkey, and put out his hand and took it, and with it he struck 1,000 men. Then Samson said, "With the jawbone of a donkey I have piled them into heaps. With the jawbone of a donkey I have slain 1,000 men." More of the same. Deedat knew, was absolutely convinced, his Allah was impotent to ever help a Muslim win a battle against 1,000 enemies. The religion Muhammad invented has no deity to support it, because Satan is not a deity. And while Satan Allah is a spirit that may roam as a lion to devour whom he may, he has no regard for the human he has deceived into following him. His evil seeks to hurt God, if possible, even by hurting humanity that Jehovah God loves and gave himself to save. Let's get to the next one in the next installment of Dismantling Deedat's Ignorant Combat Kit. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.